Hello, I am Caroline Kuhn. I'm a PhD candidate at Basque University, and I'm looking at, in my PhD, which is by its end, I'm looking at how young people don't engage with technology. So I think this is a really good question for me about the MOOCs, and so what do I think about it? The position that was set for this is about MOOCs being, so sorry, MOOCs for refugees enhancing their educational opportunities and, in a way, their livelihood, if you want. My position is strongly, I would say, against it. I think that is not true. I think it's not as simple as that. I think that access to MOOCs is not necessarily will enhance the livelihood of refugees. I do this thinking kind of on a framework that I have. I'm going to look at my picture that I'm not sure how to share with you. Oh, I know. Wait, here it is. What I did is I, here it is. Think about open educational resources as the umbrella. Then I put this under a social justice framework, and I'm using Nancy Fraser, three dimension, distribution, recognition, and representation. And then I'm using a model of DiMaggio and Hargitay that they produced in 2001, and they thought about digital inequalities, and they have five dimensions. And I'm adding my own experience of my PhD. So, at the very beginning, what I want to say here is that Sarah Lambert, she has written a paper in 2019 about openness determinism or determinism of the open. And it's this idea of these dominant discourses in the context of open educational resources that are very filled with a lot of utopian rhetoric, like open educational resources are great, open practice is great. You know, if only barriers to adoption could be overcome, then all the rest will be perfect. And these blind assumptions about collaboration, sharing, and democratization of knowledge being very good. On the other hand, there are structural barriers, which I think is my main argument. And here I hold my position based on my own experience, but also on a report that was released by the Open University about things like the cost of online access, which is huge for them, refugees, the lack of experience in online learning, which is makes them very difficult. And then DiMaggio and Hargitay argue that when that experience is not a good experience, you don't expose yourself to them anymore. And then you have less opportunity to improve your digital literacies, which is a social practice. So if you don't do it, you won't enhance it. The whole technological infrastructure, they don't have devices, they have just the mobile phones, which is tricky to learn from a mobile phone. And then that makes these learning spaces unstable and meaningless, because a social space is very important in order to engage people in the learning. And so I think that one of the things I am really aware of and I'm against is thinking that only the opportunity of the MOOC being exposed to that will improve your livelihood. I think we need to think about more community approaches to learning. We need to think about more a communal space where they have access to these devices and access to online, also to Wi-Fi and all of that. But in that space, we can also think about representation and recognition in relation with crafting maybe MOOCs with them. And then we do building capacity with them. And we make this more a human experience. So I think that only having access to MOOCs will not enhance their livelihood. So thank you very much for bearing with me in this video. And thank you so much. Bye-bye.